It's me, self-critical automaton. I'm gonna go straight to video game. So, yeah, as you can see, this is Hollow Knight. It is really, really good. To the point where the last three times I've tried to play it, I've started playing it, played it for about 4-5 hours, and then gone, you know what, this is too pretty, I can't play this just by myself, I have to share me playing it, which is perhaps a self-aggrandizing attitude to have. Regardless, I've discovered that when I try and stream, my usual style of talking constantly literally makes me physically sick, so I've decided to try and do chill streams. I've attempted this in the past and I've always ended up talking too much, so I'm just gonna try and be chill. I deleted all my old saves because I like to start new. In wilds beyond, they speak your name with reverence and regret. For none could tame our savage souls, yet you the challenge met. Under palest watch, you taught we changed, base instincts were redeemed. A world you gave to bug and beast, as they had never dreamed. From Elegy for Hallownest by Monomon the Teacher. Kind of weird to call this one of my favorite games of all time when I've only played the first 5 hours 4 or 5 times. Ah, violence. Higher beings, these words are for you alone. Your great strength marks you amongst us. Focus your soul and you shall achieve feats of which others can only dream. So, I've played a lot of Metroidvanias over the years. It's a genre I have a lot of experience with, but that I'm not generally super fond of. I've played some Metroids. I don't think I've played any Castlevanias. But I do think there's a lot to recommend them. They're kind of the every game for platformers in the way that immersive sims are the every game for first-person games. But the obsessive secret hunting begins early, and it tends to remain. So, as I was saying earlier, I've tried to make regular streaming a thing a few times in the past 2 years. Every time I do it, I inevitably end up with, unable to talk for a couple days almost because I'm all messed up in the chest and throat and so on. Which is why, as I mentioned, I've decided to try doing chill streams where I'm quiet and peaceful, and I say stuff when I have stuff to say, instead of chattering constantly all of the time. Which is a shame, because I like to chatter constantly all of the time and be funny and insightful. And I assume that's one of the things people like about my streams. But we all have to adapt and live with things. I assume I can come back here later in the game after I have more movement techniques and find secret treasures. Higher beings, these words are for you alone. Beyond this point, you enter the land of King and Creator. Step across this threshold and obey our laws. Bear witness to the last and only civilization, the Eternal Kingdom, Hallownest. Generally speaking, when you read an ancient inscription, immediate vandalism is the correct response. I do love the emptiness and coldness of the early parts of this game. One of the things I really like about it is the way that it changes as you play through, but the generalized tone of lament remains and is one of my favorite components. Yeah, I just got out of tutorial cave. It took me 6 hours. Ho there, traveler. I'm afraid there's only me left to offer welcome. Our town's fallen quiet, you see. The other residents, they've all disappeared, headed down that well one by one into the caverns below. Used to be there was a great kingdom beneath our town. It's long fell to ruin, yet it still draws folks to its depths. Wealth, glory, enlightenment, the darkness that seems to promise all things. I'm sure you too seek your dreams down there. Well, watch out. It's a sickly air that fills the place. Creatures turn mad and travelers are robbed of their memories. Perhaps dreams aren't such great things after all. Many used to come, hoping the kingdom would fulfill their desires. Hallownest, it was once called. Supposedly the greatest kingdom there ever was, full of treasure and secrets. Now it's nothing more than a poisonous tomb full of monsters and madness. Everything fades eventually, I suppose. Feeling tired? That bench may be iron, but I assure you it's quite comfortable. There's no better place to collect your thoughts before heading below. Plus, I enjoy the company, not that you seem the talkative sort. For all your mapping supplies, we will be opening soon, Iselda and Cornifer. Dusty and cold. A stone door with a simple lock. I assume I will find a key at some point. I love the repeated motifs of the ironwork as well. This is one of the most beautiful games I've ever played. And its beauty is apparent right from the start all the way through. My personal favourite are the Nautiloid street lamps. Forgotten crossroads. I remember the early zones fairly well because I played through the early parts of the game a few times. But that doesn't mean I remember where anything is. I remember the spaces, but not what's in them. It's not really a point to the amount of murder I'm doing, I don't think. Gotta get those coins, and yet I'm really only spending them on, well, I don't have anything to spend them on yet. And I will probably lose them if I die. I think that's how it works. Temple of the Black Egg. Hello there. How delightful to meet another traveller on these forgotten roads. You're a short one, but you've a strong look to you. I'm Quirrell. I have something of an obsession with uncharted places. Hey, me too. This ancient kingdom holds many fascinating mysteries, and one of the most intriguing is standing right before us. A great stone egg lying in the corpse of an ancient kingdom. And the egg, is it warm? It certainly gives off a unique air. Can it be opened? There are strange marks all over it. I do so love a mystery, and who knows what other marvels lay ever deeper below us. For so long I felt drawn here. So many tales full of wonders and horrors. No longer could I resist, I just had to see it myself. And what a time I chose to arrive. This dead world has sprung to life. The creatures are riled up and the earth rumbles, the air is thick. I wonder what could have brought it all about. To persevere in this ruin, that old nail alone will not be enough. Though that's no problem, one only has to look around. Plenty have come before us and most have met their grisly end, many more equipped than you or I. I'm sure they wouldn't mind were a fellow explorer to relieve them of their tools. It's a kindness, really. The dead should not be burdened with such things. Hello! It's nice to see you watching, as much as it is nice for me to be playing. I should point out that I'm trying to talk as little as possible on chill streams, because every time I stream, I talk way too much. I like doing that. It's good. It's good radio. It's nice on the air, but My lungs are broken. I have damage in my lungs, and if I talk for 2 hours solid, I get very sick, so. And yeah, all the designs are really cute. The characters who actually move around and do stuff are really cute, and they exist in this deeply tragic, empty, echoing world. Did you pass that town above? What a gloomy little place, and such majesty hidden right underneath. I suppose that's why they've all headed down here. Who could resist such possibilities? Truly a marvel. This guy's giving me Solera Vastora vibes. If people are going to call this game Bug Souls, I'm going to make direct allusions. It does have a very similar tone, and I'm talking too much. That was my goal for today, is to figure out how to stream without talking every single second. But I think direct comparisons between this and Dark Souls are very legitimate. I remember this guy. He's tough. Wrecked guy. I like his little rack of spare clubs as well. He's clearly never had to use them. I think these are my favorite, like, recurring creature. The adorable little sad caterpillars. Sometimes when I'm feeling sad, I make the noises they make. I'm just sitting in the kitchen quietly going, sooner or later, we'll find a map of this area. I think every zone of the game has a map.
No love.
Oh, bury my mother, pale and slight. Bury my father with his eyes shut tight. Bury my sisters two by two. And then when you're done, let's bury me too. Do you know that one? It's one of my favorites. We can sing something else if you like. You start singing and I'll join in. I bet you have a beautiful singing voice. So what are you down here for? If you came to get wealthy, just look around you. These mines are still bursting with riches. There's plenty for everyone. Just grab a pick and join in. Oh, bury the knight with her broken nail. Bury the priest? Something about a crown? I can't remember the rest of that one. Maybe I'll just hum it. I think that this roly-poly little bug in the mine is incredibly adorable. But someone once implied to me that later in the game it turns out to be some kind of... turns out to betray us in some way. I have no idea what that context could possibly be. So instead I'm just gonna go and wail on this I guess alarmingly phallic statue? Oh, that refilled my soul, but I already had a full soul. Well, I guess that was a waste. I hope they respawn. Or refill. I assume I'll get some kind of ground pound power eventually. And then the secrets of this mine will open unto me. Oh no, don't call her bug patches. That's too much of a spoiler. Stream manager's busted again. Oh well. Get stalagmited, idiot. Oh, that's my health. Whoops. Leggy bastard. I always feel terrible if I lose all the geo I collect in the early game before I unlock the bank. Or at least the shop to spend it on stuff. I get the impression that some of these enemies are natural creatures. Oh, I need the air dash to get up there. Love an air dash. And some of them are... I think the ones that are people bugs rather than bug bugs are undead in some way. Which is a really interesting take on the undead to do that in like a bug people kingdom, because the idea that they're just hollow shells that something might inhabit is kind of interesting. Oh, this is lower down on the previous chamber. This is where we started, up top of here. Oh, okay, it's the worm grandpa. So this guy, whenever you return a worm to him, it comes back to the worm nest here. And I need to check something real quick. Oh yeah, I did in fact miss a few messages because my stupid phone broke. I really need to get around to getting a... I wonder if I can get a second computer screen, like, second hand or something nice and cheap. Anyway, I'm pretty sure the bugs that don't have orange eyes are still awake and alert, and the ones that do have orange eyes are... I guess they're basically the same as the Hollows from Dark Souls. They've lost their minds and are undead in some way. But again, that that feels like a really fun take. It's almost like someone heard the term Hollows from Dark Souls and thought, well, you know what would actually be hollow if it was, oh wait, this is Grandad. If it was undead? Insects with exoskeletons. It's just a clever idea. These upper regions where Hallowness presumably used to have contact with the outside world, they're some of the sort of bleakest, emptiest, dustiest places in the game, or at least in what I've seen of the game. But despite that, they have a really lovely kind of... I don't know, there's a beautiful quality to it, the dusty echoing. The Pilgrim's Way. Travellers of Hallownest descend through verdant wilds and fungal groves to the city at this kingdom's heart. There all wishes shall be granted and all truths revealed. So I guess this is outside the city. I guess this whole underground zone is the... Oh, I know what these guys are. I think I can't fight them yet. The way that Metroidvanias work structurally is that they're platformers with a lot of zones, and you slowly unlock new abilities as you play through the game, and those new abilities are usually combat-related or movement-related, and by combining the movement and combat abilities in various ways, you can gain access to new areas. You know, you can beat a boss that was blocking off a zone. Or you can make a jump that you couldn't previously make. There's going to be a wall jumping ability later on. That's what's going to let me get through there. I mean, there might not be, but it seems like a reasonable guess because every single Metroidvania has a wall jump. I do seem to be taking things head on. This is a semi-blind run. I have played the first 4 or 5 hours, maybe 6 hours of this game several times. And every time I play it by myself, I immediately find myself going, oh, this is just too pretty, too beautiful. I care too much about this game already to not play it with other people watching. But it's too long for me to do a YouTube Let's Play of my in-depth stuff. And it's also, when I've tried to stream it previously, what I've discovered in the past 2 years is every time I stream, I get really, really sick. Which is why I'm trying to do chill streams, where I talk a lot less, although I am kind of failing at that today. But yes, so I've seen the early parts of the game, but not the later parts of the game. Ah, hello there. Come down to explore these beautiful old ruins. Don't mind me. I have a fondness for exploring myself. Getting lost and finding your way again is a pleasure like no other. We're exquisitely lucky, you and I. I'm a cartographer by trade, and I'm working on mapping this area right now. Would you like to buy a copy of my work so far? Absolutely. A map can be a useful thing, but it alone won't show you where you are. If you've not a head for directions, I suggest purchasing a compass from my wife, Iselda. She's just now opening our new map shop in Dirtmouth, selling all sorts of useful things to wanderers like yourself. She'll even sell you some of my old maps from time to time. I pop back and see her whenever I finish mapping an area. She's always excited to see me. Oh, by the way, I haven't introduced myself, have I? Yes, I should apologize for that. When you spend a lot of time by yourself with just your own thoughts, you forget the niceties of conversation. My name is Cornifer, and I've always loved exploring the world. Why, when I first hatched, I wandered off immediately, leaving my brothers and sisters and poor mother behind. That's why, as soon as I could, I moved to Dirtmouth with my wife. A huge, unending kingdom to explore right on our doorstep. Who could resist? Anyway, I'll let you return to your travels. With a little luck, we'll meet again. Be safe and farewell. How are you finding my map? I've tried to fill out as much as I can, but every map is a work in progress. If you'd like to fill out some of the map yourself, you can purchase some mapping supplies from my wife up in Dirtmouth. We've set up a little store to help make ends meet. You can find this guy in most of the areas of the game and he will sell you a map that shows you part of the game world. But the rest of it you have to fill out yourself once you get the quill upgrade. Oh, by the way, new follower, thank you very much for the follow. I didn't get a notification until just now. I'm not sure if I was a little delayed in saying so, but thank you so much for the follow. Also, I didn't crow about it at the time, but I do feel pretty proud of myself for beating the big guy with the mallet without taking a single hit. I know it's just an easy boss in the early game, and oh shit, have there been breakable walls this entire time? I'm gonna have to keep a more wary eye out, I guess. Kind of terrible at fighting these things, which is why it's a bad idea to get locked in a room with them. It's kind of alarming. I think I might head back up to the surface, just in order to try and get some of my money spent before I inevitably die horribly. Although, I wonder if the protagonist is some kind of undead himself. That is the explanation in Dark Souls for why... Oh, this is a healing spring. With these incredibly... both adorable and tragic statues vomiting in the background. You know, it's kind of out of character for me that I haven't made a single joke about cum yet, but... in such a beautiful contemplative experience, it just feels tawdry. There are going to be a lot of gloopy white fluids in this game, though. Are they going to make me fight a bunch of these things again? I know that the creatures I fight respawn, but I wonder if the money lumps also do. The monsters don't just respawn after resting, the monsters respawn anytime you re-enter a room. You can fight things in a room and then leave and they come back and they'll immediately respawn. Which is a Metroidvania thing, rather than a Dark Souls-y thing. A really nice detail is actually that a lot of the rock formations have visible fossils in. It really contributes to the dusty vibe, the sense of something ancient and forgotten. But it's also kind of aesthetically beautiful in its own right. One of the lovely things about the Natural History Museum in London, which was created, its architect wanted to create what he called a cathedral to science. And as such, he was inspired by divine architecture. But where there would have been religious carvings in a church, he had carvings of the sort of evolutionary histories of species. Although that itself is not completely unfounded, as churches themselves very often had carvings of natural scenery. If you visit old medieval churches, there's very often roots, branches, and leaves as carving motifs. Ah, time to meet my... I was going to say my favourite NPC, but I've called about two of them my favourite NPCs so far. A toll machine with the symbol of a stag. Insert geo. It's very important when you're in a new place to go around sticking your geo in things. Greetings, little one. It's been an age since I last heard the ringing of a station bell. It echoed down the stagways and called me to you. I've grown stiff and tired over these many years, and I've forgotten much, but the sound of the bell will always call me back. The stagways stretch the depths of Hallow Nest. If you want to travel them, hail me from the platform. I will take you where you need to go. It was a long time ago, but I remember when these highways and crossroads pulsed with life. These are the paths I first carried passengers through when I was young. Those travelers are long gone, and yet I still remain. Now it seems it's just you and I and the furtive creatures scratching and squirming all around us. This genial old fellow is our fast travel mechanism. Each zone has a station or two, and we can travel around on the... Again, I love the beautiful ironwork. There's a lot of really lovely visuals. Can I not? Oh, right. Perhaps I should use the enormous lever. Come to buy a map, have you? It's really my husband you should be dealing with, but what a surprise, he's headed down below. He'll pop back occasionally to deliver new maps for the store, but I do wish he'd spend a little more time up here. I've not much interest in retail myself. Now, let's see what's here for me to sell. I definitely want the quill ASAP, since that will let us record new areas on maps we have. The compass is really useful as well, but we can't afford it anymore. Oh no, the cocoons are pretty but very delicate. Please be careful around them. Perhaps I should not have smashed the one I smashed. Unfortunately, when I see something beautiful, my immediate instinct is murder. So, the compass will show me where I am, and the rest of these are just markers that will keep track of particular locations. But I can't really afford any of them. I'll need to come back as soon as I can afford a wayward compass. I wonder if this guy gets more dialogue as we go. Well, that's that question answered. I never thought I'd see such a thing. The stag station has opened. That building lay silent since before even my time. Oh, I've heard the tales of the glorious lines, a web of tunnels running all through the kingdom. Not that I'll be travelling them, mind you. I'm quite content where I am. Did you visit that temple? A strange building, I've heard, though I'd never dare the journey myself. The braver amongst us once went there to pray, and they said they felt at peace within the walls. After a while, they stopped going. I wonder what changed. I skipped one there, but she's a tall bug, the wife. I told them to take a larger house, especially given they're all empty, but they liked the look of that one. The way she has to bend just to get through the door, I wouldn't put up with it myself. The single wrought iron bench under a street lamp is such a strong piece of iconography. It's kind of lovely wherever it shows up. An easy synecdoche here for loneliness. Usually for loss as well. Okay, it looks like I need to go to the big chamber in the center, which is probably most easily accessed if I go this way. Also, I try and archive most of my streams to my YouTube channel, where I also do episodic, in-depth, old-school Let's Plays, where I talk about design and, design and themes and the artistry of the games that I play while I play them, while also making dumb jokes quite a lot. So, go check that out if you're interested. And, the once-per-stream plug is now... Well, it's not quite finished, because I also have a Patreon and a Ko-fi for anyone who feels like donating. But the plug is now finished. YouTube and the other stuff. Which way did I go? There should be a hole somewhere. Comfortable hole. Bye. That must be this way, right? Oh, hang on, this must be the... Is that the... That's the, like, a lift shafty thing. With a dome above it. I really need to get the compass. I can never keep track of where I am. Which is weird, because I actually used to be really good at orienteering when I was a kid. Which is just hiking, really, but you're smug about it. It's true, hikers are also smug, but they're a sort of a rough and tumble kind of smug. Oh wait, hang on, we're nearly back at where... Did I go through the lower thing? Man. I think I've just cycled all the way back to the other side of the map again. Also, did you log into Twitch just to make that comment? Oh, hey, the things haven't respawned. I guess I was wrong about that. I thought they respawn whenever you enter a new screen. Pretty sure that one respawned. Every time. I bought the quill, right? Which means that I haven't been There would be a new room on the map, surely. Did I get the quill? There's an inventory somewhere. There we go. Yeah. So I guess that means I haven't visited a new area yet, which means I have failed in my goal? Man, this is confusing. I'm just straight up going to go back up to the surface and buy the compass so that I can keep track of where I am. Because the shapes of the rooms don't perfectly match up. Because this is the top level, so that this room should be the room on the top right there, which means I should be able to go left and down and left and down. So then from here, there should be somewhere I haven't been. But I have been here. Oh, but that was before I had the thing. So this should be added to the map now. And yet it does not seem to be. Weird. This is where normally I would edit out me walking all the way back up. But you can't do that on streams. Unless you have an editor to go through and sit and do it all, or you feel like spending 3 hours watching yourself do stuff. Yeah, so here's the temple. That was one screen back from there. So yeah, I was right about where I was, but I can't figure out why stuff wasn't showing up. I do love the sort of extremely, like, bored teenager working a desk job. Like, bored teenage receptionist vibes that this character design has. It's remarkable how much the artist can do with so little. I didn't realize that was a charm rather than just a power I could have, like, for always. Oh, okay, I have to rest to upgrade it. I see, to update my map. I'm actually a fool. Okay. I suppose I had to learn it sometime. Okay, right, it's all added now. So that means that the long, narrow passage from one side to the other is the long, low one below. Which I actually thought was much lower down. That explains why I was confused. I've decided to take pity on them this time. Wait, hang on, that's... This is where the... Yeah, okay, I couldn't go any further over here. That explains a lot. I have to come at this from the other side. The depth of... Oh. Again, the repeated Nautiloid motif is really delightful to me. Both as a part of the kind of, like, fossilized stone vibe that the entire structures have, but also it's nice to see the elements of the natural world replicated in the ironwork of this vanished civilization. It can hopefully tell us something about what they valued. Thank you. I always feel so bad whenever I have to not go free one of the caterpillars. Bro, get a bigger house for your wife. She doesn't like stooping. I mean, it seems like Dirtmouth is just full of... Oh, that's a nice touch. That the weird wormy things are in the background. I wonder if I... There we go. I just have to do that properly. There we go. I love being good at video games. It's a nice touch that the worms are in the background anyway. In fact, the parallaxing multi-layered backdrops are just really delightful across the board. They add so much depth. One of the things I love about games as a medium is that they have a much faster turnaround than a lot of media have had with regards to just the kind of the ability to take what were the limitations of a medium and, once those limitations have been transcended, find what was really valuable about them and execute on them in a even greater sense, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. Because there's a sequence that almost all art forms tend to go through of discovering a new medium, developing it and expanding it until you hit its limitations. Yeah, I remember it being important a bit later on. I have played the first few-ish hours of this previously. I think 6 hours is the furthest I ever got into it. But yeah, so any new medium comes into existence and then it runs up against its limitations, and then later those limitations are overcome. And after those limitations are overcome, it moves on to expand its borders up until the new limitations. But then there's a movement back towards what the aesthetics that were necessary under the old limitations. You know, if people could have put high definition, high resolution artwork in games in 1995, they would have done so. The reason they didn't was because they couldn't. And because they couldn't, they had to develop things like pixel art. Or in the 80s for pixel art, I suppose. And then years later, after that limitation is completely irrelevant, the aesthetics of that style, necessitated by those limitations, are expanded and used for their own merit, not simply because they are the only thing that is possible under the limitations. And I think that's true for almost every component. I think that's true, for example, in the parallaxing backgrounds here. Anyway, I've belabored my point a little bit too much. I'm sure you all get what I mean. God, I love the noises they make. I'll probably find a lantern eventually. Except it'll be some kind of like cool bug lantern. Like a glowworm in a snail shell or something. Last time I fought one of these, I didn't take a single hit. I'm a bit disappointed in myself this time. But yes, those sounded like very good plushies. Well, my phone's completely lost its internet access now, which means I can't see chat. But that's probably fine. That feels like a boss room. I'm gonna see what's down here first. Ah, that feels like a boss chest. Alright, time to get my butt kicked. Hard same. Damn, is that not enough? Rule of threes, surely. Oh, that was enough. Hoisted by his own petard. I I can't offer him knightly mercy then. I have to slaughter him. City crest. Stone slab bearing the crest of the Hallownest capital city. Has an insert on the back that would fit into a slot. Oh hey, what the... The hell it... Is that just a cute little detail? Or can I do something with this? Alright, you're free to go. I guess you could call that accessory to murder. Yeah, they really... Every single... Like, I don't have a single complaint about this game. Like... And this is me talking. Like, whose whole, like, internet presence and YouTube channel is built on being a critic. Like, obviously critic doesn't mean critical, but, you know. I mean, I haven't played all of it, but I do not have many complaints about it. And it's just... It's beautiful, and it's adorable, and it's full of clever detail, and people thinking about the implications of the nature of this society, and the artists attempting to imply stuff about the nature of this society, and oh shit, are these the masks that I am wearing, except tons and tons of them all over the place? That seems concerning, to say the least. It seems like maybe this is a place where I shouldn't be, considering that a zillion of the masks that people of my culture wear are just lying all over the floor and there's no people wearing them. Plus, it makes bone noises when I walk around. The Miyazaki poison swamp is relatively early and it's not- actually, no. There might be a couple different poison swamps in this game, actually, but they're far less, like, miserable than Miyazaki swamps, at least. Oh, hell yeah, that's a good noise. Oho, who is that creeping out of the darkness? My, you're looking grim. A strange, empty face and a wicked-looking weapon. Something important has drawn you to Hallownest's corpse, but I won't ask what. Perhaps the reason you found me is because you need my help. Say no more, friend. I'm going to give you a gift. A nasty little spell of my own creation. It's just perfect for a little one like you. Ho ho ho. Okay, cool, but like, why? I tend not to trust free gifts, especially not when they're from sinister sorcerers. Especially not when they're from sinister sorcerers who currently are standing upon the stacked faces of my people. And then put me in a cage also. Like, I don't know about you, but generally speaking, like, I mean, the faces are bad enough, but don't also put me in a cage. Oh, you've woken at last. I apologize. Perhaps I should have warned you about the power of that spell. I was watching over you as you slept, but I seem to have slipped away myself. Now we're awake, I was wondering whether you would do me a small favor. Not as a repayment for my gift, of course, but simply because we're friends. You see, a horrid great beast has made its home in the heart of this temple. Such disrespect! I'd be quite grateful if you were to venture deeper in and slay it for me. It's a hardy creature, but with your new power, you're more than a match for it. Good luck with this small favour, my friend. Also, I've not been reading out the Dark Souls laughs that everyone laughs with, but I think you can all just imagine it for yourselves. Are you wondering about this gate between us? It's a curious thing, but this door will not open until you have slain the creature. Don't worry about it. I'm sure the spirits of my ancestors will watch over you. Maybe I'm being too harsh on this guy. Maybe this is more like a graveyard and he's the graveyard keeper. There's no reason to assume that he put all of these masks of murdered people here personally. The one thing I've never really got the hang of is air combat. It's one of the reasons I don't play a lot of Metroidvanias, as I tend to get killed in midair. I still think all of these things look incredibly phallic, although it's a nice detail that this one's been festooned with the masks. I wonder if it was the shaman's doing, or if it's just like that here for some reason. Was that it? I thought there was a bigger one. Soul catcher, used by shamans to draw more soul from the world around them. Gets me more soul whenever I hit things, so I get more mana, basically. That's nice. Hey, I killed your thing. So it's done then, you've slain the beast. The poor thing, it must have been terrified of you. It used to be quite docile, but then the rancid air in these caverns filled it with some ancient rage. Still, you did what had to be done. You have my gratitude. Of course, we both know you wouldn't have made it through without that spell of mine. And look, the gate between us has opened. I'm sure you're eager to move on. Farewell and have faith. Whatever you're seeking, it'll find you. What am I seeking? Why do you hesitate? You'll get nothing more from me, I'm afraid. Though I do admire your persistence. I love this fucking tsundere shaman. I'm gonna give you this spell. It's not because I like you or anything. But also you have to go do a thing for me. Oh, please, please help me. Please kill this horrible monster. Oh, you killed the poor little beast, the poor little thing that did nobody any harm. Why, it was more scared of you than you were of it. Which is understandable, though. You know, it was not a very scary movie. Sorry I missed you. If you're feeling lost, why not pop up to our store in Dirtmouth and purchase a map of the area? Available now for an excellent price. I do have lots of money. So I think there's a couple more areas I can explore as yet, but the main thing I can do now is jump into the spikes for no reason and die. The main thing I can do now is go to the place to the far left where there was one of those anteater bugs. I can't remember what they're called. The ones with the long snouts. Maybe it's a kind of like a weevil or something. Anyway, I can go kill it now that I have the ranged attack spell. Which will grant us access to the next zone, which will grant me some kind of a power, which will grant us access to the zone after that, which will grant me some kind of power, which will grant me access to the zone after that, and so on until this game is eventually completed, because that's how a Metroidvania do. Oh, beans. As the residents of Hallownest themselves can attest, it's very easy to fall in a hole and die. I do want to check the rest of this ground floor and see if I can go anywhere. Ouch. Ooh, a street sign. It's a lovely little detail that they do have the signs and stuff all over the place. Also these peculiar masked statues, which every time I see them I find myself wondering, are these mummies? Are these the mummified remains of inhabitants, or are they statues? Are they fossils? Petrified? That's elevator, baby. Presumably we either get into it from the other side or we get to it from somewhere else in the city. Based on this street sign, which I would assume is a street sign indicating the way to the city, that's the main elevator down in towards the city itself, because we are just in the sort of the hinterlands of this once great city-state. So I imagine after we visit the city we'll unlock that elevator. Hell yeah. Another phallic statue to beat relentlessly. Haha, I love violence. Haha, I crave destruction. Oh, interesting. Jesus, was that like a boss? Gross, gross, gross. Imagine the first instance of your consciousness, your first live experience of your entire existence, the very first experience of a newly conscious being, is violence and then death. How grim. That reminds me, actually. The boss we fought previously, the first boss of the game, the big guy, who was revealed to be a little grub inside someone else's armor. Presumably that was actually someone else's body. He was inhabiting the body of something as a parasite, but occupying it after it died, I suppose. So I suppose the glowy white things are some kind of parasitic entity. I wonder if they're connected to the orange stuff, which I think is what makes people into undead. Or are you oaf, you wield your nail like a club. Esme, how much deeper do we have to go? Oh, what? Who are you? I see. This old village. What a strange dream to have led me down here. If you had not found me, I don't think I ever would have woken. I'm Sly. Usually I live an uneventful life up in Dirtmouth. The air in these ruins doesn't agree with me, so I'd best be getting back. If you return above, come and see me. I'm probably the friendliest face left there, and I can thank you properly for your good deed. What were you doing down here? You're exploring then? Very brave. Plenty of courageous wanderers have been lost to the hunger of these old caverns. You have your nail, though, and I can tell just by looking that you know how to wield it. You're a weird little fellow. I like how variable the bugs all are, though. There's clearly a kind of a class of bug entity, which is... or our erstwhile protagonist. Is he the Hollow Knight? I assumed that this little guy is the Hollow Knight, because the title's Hollow Knight and there's a big picture of him. So I wonder if people like this are knights. Maybe that's what's up. Because I think there's different kinds of bugs that have these white masks. But not all the bugs have the masks. And there's plenty of other kinds of bugs around. And there's differently shaped ones who have the masks as well. Sounds like someone brushing their teeth. Looks like a cable car. A door with an open slot. Okay, I guess I'll get some kind of crest that will allow me to activate these cable cars later on. Which is a phrase you'll probably be hearing a lot, with different things swapped out for cable car and crest. Whoops. Sorry about that, chum. I accidentally blasted you with the focused totality of my psychic might. Seems like overkill. On the other hand, I do hate fighting them. Money. Well, there is such a thing as overkill if you needed that energy for something else. Oh my god, these ones have swords too. I'm no longer the big fish in a small pond. I thought that was what made me special. I'm gonna assume that I can't downstrike to bounce off of spikes. Oh my god, I can. This changes everything. A whole new world. A whole new point of view. Oh, focus totality of my psychic might was absolutely 90s Marvel, but it actually predates that. As a phrase, that focused totality is a Claremontism that goes back all the way to his 1970s reboot of the X-Men line. Basically, that kind of phraseology and that specific phrase both originate in the X-Men stories of the 70s after the 1974 X-Men reboot. See, this is why people come to my channel. You know, comic book info. But it's one of the many Claremontisms that just live forever in my brain rent-free. The comics that I really love, or at least the superhero comics that I really love, are the Claremont X-Men run, really. That's... actually, classic Spider-Man is very good as well. The Steve Ditko run from the 60s is delightful. It's a very common line. It's just a phrase that shows up all the damn time when psychics are doing psychic things in Claremont's X-Men comics. Body and soul, that's another one that he says all the damn time. Or rather, he puts into the mouths of his characters all the damn time. Oh no! Now I'm the idiot who got stalagmited. I guess that also means I'm the idiot who got hoisted by their own petard as well. Haha, vandalism! Haha, wanton destruction! Haha! There's definitely something about the kind of empty-eyed hooliganism that I absolutely love. Because he's such a sort of a interesting figure, the main character. He's either this kind of like naive attitude with his big wide eyes, or he's got sort of a kind of a quiet solitude, a kind of a nobility to him. But then whenever he's just sort of blank-facedly smashing shit, it really has the energy of like, I don't know, a child who doesn't really know why they're smashing things with a hammer, but just knows that they're doing it. You know, completely no thoughts, just doing stuff. Whoops. Jesus, somebody should put up a fence, maybe? Or like a warning sign? You know, watch your step, you might fall into the ancient corpse of a once beautiful civilization.
Papanada.
Hello, yes, I would like all of your finest pins. Quite enough for all of them, which is tragic, really. But I got all of the useful ones. The other ones are ones that will mark, like I can use to mark things manually, I think. Although don't quote me on that. Oh shit, that guy was the shopkeeper? Oh, I just wasted all of my money. Oh, I got bamboozled. Oh, what a turn. Our shopkeeps come home. I just wandered back in. I'd hoped for grand tales of his time below, but he seems to remember almost nothing. Maybe it was all too much for him. If you're interested in his wares, watch out. He drives a hard bargain, that one. No competition, that's the problem. It's bad for the market. Not that he's complaining. I mean, monopolies are extremely bad for consumers, generally speaking. Ah, hello, I knew we'd meet again. How do you like my cozy little store? I've made myself pretty comfortable here, selling old trinkets to travellers like yourself. If you're planning a trip below, I have several items that may improve your chance of survival. Oh, yeah, damn, this guy's got loads of stuff that I want to buy. I shouldn't have wasted all my money on stupid pretty markers for my stupid pretty map. So we'll be coming back here later when I actually have more money again. I think that's more or less where we'll call it for tonight. I definitely talked a lot more than I wanted to, which is unfortunate. It's good for you guys, because it makes for good TV. Unfortunate for me, because I can feel my throat starting to hurt, and that's usually a bad sign. After all, the reason why I want to do these chill streams is because I have discovered that whenever I stream and I talk too much, I end up with a like just a chest infection or a sore throat. Like I just think I'm just permanently damaged, which is a shame. So I'm just gonna head over to where we will gain access to the new zone, and that will be it for me for today. But that's a little ways to go before we get there. Thank you. I was trying to show off. So that's what hubris tastes like. Ah, I'm glad you had fun. Also, I forgot all about the granddad. When you save the worms, he gives you coins based on the number of worms you've previously saved. The more you save, the more he gives you. Thanks, Grandpa. I will go and buy all of the candy. Which is the traditional thing that one does with money given to you by grandparents. Ha, here we go. I read this earlier, but the Pilgrim's Way. Travellers of Hallownest descend through verdant wilds and fungal groves to the city at this kingdom's heart. There all wishes shall be granted and all truths revealed. Yep, this is definitely where we're going to be coming back next time. So that is going to be it from me for today. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you later. Please join me again. If you enjoyed this, please like, subscribe, and share. I also stream on Twitch, and I now have a Discord server for stream scheduling. You can contribute to my existence on Ko-fi or Patreon, and all of those links are in the video description. Thanks so much for watching.